can run on for a long time, run on for a long time, run on for a long time. Sooner or later, gotta cut you down. Sooner or later, gotta cut you down. Go tell that long-tongued liar. Go and tell that midnight rider. Tell the rambler, the gambler, the backbiter. Tell him that God's gonna cut him down. Tell him that God's gonna cut him down.
You know I'm wanting to hunt down that mud seal.
I know that's what you're wanting, but we can't track him. Even if we could, it would take us weeks, maybe months to get him.
You're acting like I'm a coffee boiler. I've tried many times to find our Amos, and that's how we ended up here, in this god-awful town.
Now, De Niro, I know you better than that. You're a regular old curly wolf.
Look, Amos, we've got to track Harlan down. He stole my wife, Ruth.
We've been trying for nearly a year. If we ain't got him now, we never will.
Amos, you know well as I do that Harlan's knife is so dull it wouldn't cut hot butter.
Oh Lord, that man is dreadfully dumb, but we can't seem to track him. I don't know if I can continue on like this. I got a family, De Niro.
Is that a bluff, or did you mean it for real play?
I surely am not lying to you. I gotta call her quits.
Amos, I need you. You're one of the best trackers. Who could ever replace you? You make wonderful bear signs and you're someone to ride the river with.
I know it, but I hired you someone else to take my spot. Sure, he can't make donuts, but he's a better tracker than I am, and much younger.
Oh, for God's sake, please tell me it's not Julius.
Pack your bags, Mr. De Niro. We let a shuck for Arkansas tomorrow.
How could you do this to me, Amos?
Look, I know that Julius is a dude and you ain't too fond of him, but he's a powerful good tracker.
He better be.
Look, Mr. De Niro, Mr. Amos was telling me that you don't like me very much because I am from a higher quality of life. Although we might have our differences, I guarantee you we will find Mr. Harlan and somebody will end up dead.
Amos, don't lie. And Julius, you do cut us well, but I consider you to be a deadbeat.
Look, Mr. De Niro, I respect your opinion, but I do believe it's a little outdated. I've honed my tracking skills, and I have no doubt in my mind that you will be surprised.
I don't care for any of that. What trail are we following right now?
Well, when I received a letter from Mr. Amos expressing how he wanted my services, I began to track Mr. Harlan. I found out he's just over these mountains right here. I figured that out from the Indians who traveled through our little town. They said they had heard of Mr. Harlan and he'd come from Arkansas. They had mentioned that he'd acquired a new wife, and she did not seem very happy with him. They said he planned to stay down there in a town they call Fandango.
You're a flannel mouth liar. Ruth can fight like Kilkenny cats. I know she wouldn't let some idiot like Harlan boss her around.
All right, Mr. De Niro, put the gun away. It'd hurt us both if you were to shoot me.
I don't care continental weather or hurt you. I'd rather be doing this search alone than with you. At this point, you're just annoying me. Tell him in Polish. Give me another reason why I shouldn't clean your plow.
Because Mr. Harlan is riding over the ridge with your wife right now.
Ruth, I've come to take you home. Shoot him, he's outnumbered.
I ain't aiming to shoot Harlan. I'm aiming to shoot you.
Julius, what in God's name are you doing? Point the gun at Harlan.
I'm sorry, Mr. De Niro. Mr. Harlan paid me more money than Mr. Amos.
I ain't aiming to shoot you, Ruth.
Indians passed through town saying they heard tale that Julius was on the Harlan side and they were planning to gun you down. As soon as I heard, I saddled up to find you.
I ain't ever going anywhere without you and your bear sabs again.
Cowboy went riding out one dark and windy day. Up on a ridge he rested as he went along his way. When all at once a mighty herd of red-eyed cows he saw plowing through the ragged skies, and up a cloudy draw. Their brands were still on fire and their hooves were made of steel. Their horns were black and shiny and their hot breath he could feel. A bolt of fear went through him as they thundered through the sky, for he saw the riders coming hard and he heard their mournful cry. Yippee-yi-yo, faces gaunt, their eyes were blurred, their shirts all soaked with sweat. He's riding hard to catch that herd, but he ain't caught them yet. Cause they've got to ride forever on that range up in the sky. All the horses snorting fire as they ride on, hear their cry. Riders loped on by him, he heard one call his name. If you want to save your soul from hell riding on our range, then cowboy, change your ways. If they are with us, you will ride, trying to catch the devil's herd across these endless skies.